Good morning and welcome to the ninth edition of the JMM Weekly Wrap-Up, providing with a summary from the past week on top headlines. Secondary producer of nutraceutical, seafood products and premium marine ingredients, New Zealand Coastal Seafoods released their quarterly activities report. Particular highlights include over a 220% increase from the March 2021 quarter cash receipts. New Zealand Coastal Seafood continued to make significant progress on the development and commercialization of its flagship marine collagen product, with the toll processing agreement for extraction now finalized. Canyon Resources announced that it's received firm commitments from existing and new institutional and sophisticated investors to raise $6 million. This money will be used to advance the Minamatap project in Cameroon. Gold and copper explorer Godolphin Resources released their quarterly report. Highlights include follow-up drilling awaiting completion at Copper Hill East and assay results from Lewis Pond, which both target extensions to the existing estimated mineral resource. Online sports betting, entertainment and technology company PlayUp received regulatory approvals by the Northern Territory Racing Commission to soft launch its next generation online betting and entertainment platform. The newly launched platform encompasses modernized mobile-first front-end functionality with an automated back-end that will revolutionize the way society trades racing and sport. Gold development and mineral exploration company Tulla Resources announced that the Green Lantern infill drilling results provides confidence that mine life from the Scotia Mining Centre will be extended beyond the current Phase 1 feasibility plan. Deeper drilling in the latest round has returned wider high-grade intersections at depth, demonstrating additional underground potential following completion of open pit. American Pacific Borates announced they have delivered a substantial exploration target to support proposed resource expansion drilling activities scheduled for later this year. This provides the potential to materially increase existing JORC code compliant mineral resource. Premium base metal exploration company Cyprium Metals announced that they have intersected 180 metres of sulfide ore grade copper from 10 metres at Nanadine. Perth-based mineral exploration company Victory Goldfields announced that it's commenced an auger drilling program. The auger drilling program of 826 holes is designed to identify drill targets based on gold in-soil geochemical results. Diamond drilling is also scheduled to commence next week on the Kudadi project. In the health sector, data-backed treatment, development and clinical services company, Emeria Limited, announced it has entered into an exclusive agreement with the University of Western Australia to examine and expand a unique library of proprietary MDMA-like compounds or analogues, which has been developed over the last 10 years. Betting data and analytics company BetMakers Technology Group announced that a landmark bill to authorise fixed odds wagering on horse races through fixed odds wagering system was passed unanimously in both Senate and General Assembly in New Jersey on the 21st of June and has now been signed by the Governor of New Jersey to become law. Legalising fixed odds betting on horse racing in the US has been a pillar of BetMakers' strategic vision. Electricity provider Locality Planning Energy provided shareholders with an update on trading for the month of July 2021. LPE has continued its pattern of consistent customer growth as the company begins the 2022 financial year with another positive month, with uplift of 600 customers in July 2021. This represents another consistent month of growth as the company continues to execute on its organic growth strategy. Thank you for tuning in for the JMM Weekly Wrap-Up. Until next time.